In this tutorial, we'll show you how to integrate data directly between Oracle NetSuite and a planning application. Before creating data integrations, make sure you have source and target systems defined. You register source and target systems in data management. After registering your NetSuite source system, run the initialization process to extract a list of saved searches from NetSuite, which creates a target application entry in data management for each saved search. Period and category mappings are also defined in data management. For more information on tasks you perform in data management, visit the Cloud Help Center and view the documentation for administering data management for Oracle Enterprise Performance Management Cloud. To start defining my integration, I'll open the data integration workflow. Data integration guides you through a workflow to complete the necessary data management setup tasks. Navigate between tasks by clicking a task on the workflow bar or these buttons. Enter a name. Descriptions are optional. You define locations to specify your source and target systems. After creating a location, you can use it for other integrations. I'll select my data source and my target. Then, select the target plan type. I'll select my category. This maps to the scenario in my application. You can add or edit attributes assigned to a location. Save your integration before proceeding to the next task in the workflow. You can also continue working on your integration at a later time. You map dimensions to specify how source dimensions map to the dimensions in the target application. In legacy data management, this is referred to as defining import formats. If the import format has already been defined, the source and target columns are mapped automatically. If you are adding a new import format or editing an existing import format, select which columns are mapped from the source system and how data is staged during the import process. You can concatenate fields by mapping multiple source columns to a single target dimension. You can also use source or target expressions to perform simple data transformations. Aside from the standard expressions, you can use the SQL expression type to perform more complex transformations. Next, map members. Map members is where you define your data load mappings. You map members to identify how source dimensionality translates to target dimensionality based on source values during the data load. Member mappings define relationships between source members and target dimension members within a single dimension. You can also use expressions instead of mappings. For cases not addressed by an expression, you must define a member mapping for each target dimension. In Options, you can select General and Target options for your data integrations. For General options, verify or modify your category, plan type, and calendar options. For Period mapping type, you select Default to use the global period keys and prior period keys defined in data management. Select Explicit if you want to use period source mappings defined with the explicit mapping type. For target options, choose options specific to a location, such as the load method, batch size, whether to enable the drill region, or select any purge data file options. Target options selected here are dynamic and local to the specific target application. You can filter the data you want to import on the Filters tab. I'll save and close my integration. Before I run my integration, I'll open a form to display the data intersection I'll be loading. The data point of view is set to the plan scenario, FY18 year, international sales entity, working version, and tablet product. I'll be loading data to the January period for these accounts. I'll go back to Data Exchange and run my integration. I'll accept the default selections for import and export mode. Replace clears all the data for the POV in the workbench. Merge overwrites existing data. If data does not exist, it loads the new data. I'll set the start period to January 2018. The end period was updated after I selected the start period. Verify your selections, then run the integration. Click Refresh until the status displays a green checkmark. Let's take a look at the data in the workbench. Here's the data I'm importing. I'll open a form to verify that the data loaded successfully. Data was loaded successfully to my planning application. In this tutorial, you saw how to integrate data directly between Oracle NetSuite and a planning application. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.